Hi, Sunil sir. Welcome to the show. How are you, sir?
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me on the show.
Good afternoon, sir. So thank you for your time. Sir, what's your view on agri commodity?
I think the pick of the commodities in agri have been chana, soybean, and even the edible oil segment. It is quite volatile these days, and that's why it has grabbed attention of a lot of traders and participants. Especially if we look at soybean, the kind of rally we have witnessed in soybean. It has come to most of the traders as a surprise, because the prices are close to 7,570 level, up by almost 70%, which is not a small number. Ideally, the fundamentals that are driving the prices is that the USDA data determines that overall supply for this year will be low, and the stock level is close to 12-year low if we talk about the USDA data. So global level, the consumption is expected to be better. And even there is a concern over the plantation in the US. They are expecting 2.5-3% lower plantation this year. That may also impact the output. Plus, even the soya meal demand in the domestic market is also decent. And overall, I think the Brazil and Argentina's front crushing activities have also started. Even from that space, we are seeing some demand coming in for international soybean. So overall, if we look at global supply and demand scenario this year, the supply will remain tight and the demand is expected to be good. And from the domestic perspective, since the rupee depreciated, it is supporting prices. Plus, India's soya meal export numbers have actually been phenomenal. The soya meal export numbers are sixfold grown. Now, that's the reason why we are seeing domestic front appreciation in the prices. However, the prices are in overbought zone at the moment. We are seeing soybean May contract trading at 7,570 level now. There is a possibility of some pullback happening because some profit booking may also happen. And there are some institutions that are also saying there is a possibility of some traders speculating and building positions on the buyer side to create a short squeeze. So that is also some of the traders are kind of seeing that as a news because of the sudden rise in soya bean prices that we have witnessed. So overall, from a strategy perspective, this looks to be active counter for now. Very short term, we are expecting maybe small correction towards 7,200 level. So somebody who is willing to take intraday or a couple of days position, one can go short with a strict stop loss of 7,650, sell around 7570 range, and target 7,200. That is for a couple of days time. Like I said, one has to maintain a strict stop loss of 7,650, because we are expecting some profit booking to happen here, and some consolidation will also happen. So from that perspective, we recommend a sell for a very short term period. And the second commodity in our focus is chana. Chana prices have also performed really well in the recent past. Currently it is trading at 5,517 range. Government has already started procuring chana at MSP. This year the crop expected is lower than the anticipated number because of crop damage. We have short supply in the market, and that's the reason why the stockists are kind of building up the inventory. At the moment, the inventory with stockists is low, and they'll be building up the inventory, and the demand is also coming from that particular space. Apart from that, even the local mandis are also witnessing tight supply, and that is supporting the chana prices in the short term. However, the prices have discounted the fundamentals. We are not expecting chana prices to trade beyond 5700 rupees quintal, but still 5700 rupees means another 200 rupees appreciation is what we may expect. So we recommend a buy in chana around 5450 range with a stop loss of 5350, and one can target 5700 maybe in next week's time. So for a week we are bullish by 200 points for chana. Coming to the edible oil segment, soya oil prices have also performed well. Like I mentioned, the reasons or the fundamentals that are supporting soybean prices obviously are supporting the soya oil prices as well. Currently, the soya oil May contract is trading at 1409. Strong US export demand and tightening US supplies is supporting the soya oil prices overall. And production prospect for palm oil is also low this month, and hence soya oil demand is kind of increasing. And even the rupee depreciation part is also supporting soya oil prices. So from that perspective, overall soya oil fundamentals remain positive. The global demand supply estimates suggest towards higher exports and lower year-ending stock, and that's the reason why even the prices may stay firm. However, most of the fundamentals that I mentioned have discounted the prices. We may see some consolidation, like I mentioned, even in soybean, we can expect some consolidation happening. We can expect some consolidation happening in soya oil as well. So one can sell soya oil around 1410 in the domestic market, the May contract. One can keep a surplus of 1420, and one can target 1380 as a target in a couple of days' time. So maybe by Tuesday or Wednesday next week, we may see the prices stay close to 1380 there for soya oil contract. And from that perspective, from that point, again, one can look forward to a buy, because overall long-term fundamentals remain positive. This is a short-term correction is what we are expecting. On the crude palm oil front, the prices are again firm. Overall, edible oil segment has performed well. Since we take international prices for CPO, rupee weakening has supported domestic prices. Now it is trading close to 1,234 as such. And like I said, even for CPO, the demand remains good and supply remains tight. Indonesian biodiesel program also is one of the fundamental factors that supports the prices. And I think overall globally, if we see, the weather is also unfavorable due to the dry weather. The overall output is expected to be lower than what was anticipated, and plus the demand is also increasing, so that should drive the prices slightly up. So in the short term, we are expecting a buy around 1220 level for CPO. One can target 1250 first target, 1270 as a second target. One can keep a stop loss of 1200 for this commodity.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir. Very interesting to talk to you, sir. And looking forward to have more such conversation.
Thank you very much for having me on the show. Thank you very much.